Hello, Ken Spriggs here with beginning a new build on a 3D printed kit that I received from Shapeways. I showed it in my last video for the IPMS Nationals. It's going to be a little mini Jupiter 2, very, very super tiny, and it'll be my first build of an all 3D printed kit. So let's go ahead and take a look at this awesome little kit. All right, and this is going to be my next build. It is a fully 3D printed Jupiter 2 from Lost in Space. It has an interior. I'll take the top off here in a moment and show that to you, but you've got an interior in there as well, which is pretty awesome. All right, so this will be my first fully 3D rendered kit. As I've said, I've used 3D printed parts before to augment kits, but I've never built a kit that is fully 3D printed. So this will be my first. And there's a little landing gear that come with it. All right, so this is pretty phenomenal. It's approximately 1/350 scale, so it's very tiny, as you can see, my hands, my fingers. Let me go ahead and show you the inside of that. All right, and here are the parts separated, except for the other two landing gear. I just took one of them off, so they're very tiny. So you have a bottom of the saucer, nice little notches here for the interior to sit on, and you can see the nice holes through the fusion core, really nicely detailed. And it's pretty cool. There are holes on the sides, as you can see here, and there are holes on the bottom. They're separated, so that's going to be really cool when I light that up. It even has a little fin sticking out, which are quite awesome on there, and little ridges on the top. This is an excellent, excellent 3D printed part. It has the you can see just a little bit of indentation for the lower window. And there's a little bit of a recessed area for the landing gear, as you can see as well. Okay, so that's pretty cool. We have the top of the ship with the open window. And also the little window next to the door and the window in the door. Okay, you have the little recessed circles here on the top. Not quite sure what those are supposed to be. The dome on top, which I'm going to redo in a clear. And there's the inside of it. So, all right. So that's quite awesome as well. And then we have the interior, which I'm going to do some lighting on and augment it somewhat. But you have the little control center in the middle there with the dome. You have the elevator there in the back. The six freezing tubes, which I want to redo in a clear. I have some thick fiber optic, which is about that thickness. You have the pilot's chairs right there, kind of cool. And just a little bit of detail there for the controls. Okay, and it's all in a nice clear or translucent material. So a lot of these things I can have lights coming through them, which is kind of cool. So all right, so I washed all the parts with some mild soap and water, scrubbed them down pretty good and let them dry overnight, rinsed them off. You really want to do that with 3D printed parts because there was some obvious residue on them, and that would really affect your paint sticking to it. So I wanted to get them nice and clean and go ahead and let them dry thoroughly. So one of the things I want to do, and I started playing with a little bit, is to make a clear dome on the top. This dome is pretty cool though. It actually has a hole built into it. You could put a light right up in there and just light that dome, but it wouldn't be transparent. And I think having a clear dome with maybe the tiniest little bit of a silver machinery in it would make it look more realistic. And I'm playing with some ideas to be able to have a light blinking on there as well, or possibly two lights so it looks like it's rotating, kind of a thing. So what I did was I took some of this quick mold, amazing mold putty, and I just made a little mold of the top of that. And then I don't really have any clear resin, so I tried to use some 5-minute epoxy. Unfortunately, because this is rough, it came out rough, so it wasn't clear. So what I'll probably end up doing, which I've done before, is once I get this all painted and that cut out and I have the lights or the machinery in there that I want, I'll just take some 5-minute epoxy, keep this level, and just drop it onto there so it forms a dome, which it's prone to do anyway, and then just let that dry clear, and I think that'll be pretty cool. So that'll be something I'll do towards the end of the kit. The interior was fantastically designed. The tolerances are perfect. It literally fits like a glove right down in that little groove. So that's really cool. And there's still room underneath it, obviously, for some lights and some wiring and things like that. Generally, what I'm looking to do as far as lighting, I want to replace the freezing tubes with some clear fiber optic. This is very thick fiber optic. I'm going to get some other ones too, maybe something a little thinner, but this is very close to it, where I can cut off just a length of it and just glue it down and have a light coming up from the bottom. So I want those to be lit up and clear, or white, and then I want lights back here to show the blue glowing through as well. Maybe something with a little bit of green for up here for the controls, but that's probably going to be about it. And I think the predominant view that you're going to see from the cockpit window is going to be the blue and the white of the freezing tubes. That's going to be the main thing you're going to see anyways. So. Alright, so now that I have these all cleaned and ready to go, the first thing I want to do is get on a coating of Tamiya Fine Surface Primer, which is in white, to give it a nice base, and then also to see if there's anything else I need to worry about as far as detail or roughness. I did take some very thin sandpaper, not thin, I'm sorry, some fine sandpaper, 2000 grit, and I went over all of the surfaces on the top and the bottom to give it a bit of a smoother finish. So it feels smooth, but it's hard to tell if there's any other things I need to cover. If they're just some light, like print lines, I think a lot of that will be taken care of when I paint it. Ultimately, what I'm wanting to do is use alclads to paint it like a shiny aluminum. So what I'll do is I'll put on the gloss black base first of all, which will also help with some masking. And then I have polished aluminum, which looks pretty good, and that will go over the top. It's a pretty easy kit to paint as far as the outside. It's just all aluminum is all it is. Even the landing gear is all aluminum. Everything's aluminum. So the only kind of other colors you're going to see are going to be the lights in the bottom spinning around, and you're going to see the light in the top, and then the lights in the interior as far as the blues and that kind of thing. So, but other than that, the outside of the ship is just silver, so that's a fairly easy paint job, and I think the outclouds will do a good job for that. So, all right, so let's go ahead and see about getting a primer coat on that, and then we'll see how we're looking as far as the
the detail on this kit. All right, as you can see from the previous stills, I began to prime the Jupiter 2. I'm using Tamiya's Fine Surface Primer in white. It's a really awesome primer. It's very thin, it goes on light, but it really lets you see any blemishes at all that have to be smoothed out. And being a 3D printed model, there were some areas where there were some deep print lines, a little bit rougher areas. So before I did that though, I showed that I taped off the top and I cut out that dome. It looks like it's still solid because I have a piece of tape underneath it. But the hole's open now and I just kept the merest of a lip on the edge. You can barely see it because I'll be putting some 5-minute epoxy in there to make a clear dome. But the primer went on well. I did have to do some sanding of a lot of the blemishes. I also used this plastic putty from Vallejo. Put a little bit of that on there. It's a real smooth water-based putty. You smooth it on, let it dry for about 30 minutes, and then you can sand it down as well. But I also then used some very light, fine sandpaper, 1,000, 2,000 grit, and I did some wet sanding, just dip it in some water, and then sand it along the different spots, and it helps to shine it up a lot more. So the bottom was actually fairly smooth. It didn't have too many issues at all. It's nice and even, but I went over it lightly with some wet sanding just to kind of smooth out that image. And once I get the gloss black base from Alclad on it, that will help to self-level any rough spots and make them smoother. And then I'll get the aluminum on top of that. The top took a lot more work, but I did get it fairly down to where I need it to be, nice and smooth. So what I'm gonna do is go over this, both halves of this again with one more coat of the fine surface primer and let that dry, and then we'll be ready to hopefully start on the next step of the painting. All right. All right, so I got the gloss black on and let that dry overnight, and then I got a coating of the polished aluminum. It's a little too silvery and shiny. It should be a little darker of an aluminum. I wasn't quite sure because I have the two different kinds. I have the polished aluminum, and then I also have just aluminum, which is a little darker. So what I'll probably end up doing is going over this with one more coat of the darker aluminum to just kind of even it out a bit. But other than that, it came out nicely metallic. Okay, there's the bottom. And that didn't obscure the holes any for the engine core. The inside, I put a coating of flat black on it. And then I put another coating of the white primer to give it some reflective abilities. You're seeing that square because I had a piece of tape over that, and then a little bit of the silver got underneath it. So, same with the top. To do some light masking. Okay, and then the landing gear. Now, on the landing gear, if you look on the back, they're really shiny, because that was the smoothest part of this material. I'm glad the rest of it wasn't that smooth, because I really don't want it to look that smooth and shiny, it would look too artificial, look too much like a toy. So I'm gonna have to probably just spray a little bit over top of those so they don't look like polished steel, which the kit wouldn't look like. The rest of it seems to be okay. Just anywhere where there was really smooth detail, even though there are some ridges in there, so. Okay. All right. I also got a package in the mail from Evan Design, so I got the remaining light components that I need. Let me show you those here. So I want to, besides the interior being lit, I want to have the dome lit and look like it's rotating. And I want the lights in the core to be rotating on the kit. So I looked over a couple products that they had, and one that really will do what I want is called a rotator, surprisingly. It's designed to be used in like police cars and fire engines, that kind of thing, to show the rotating light on top. And it comes pre-wired with three lights, a little teeny thing here, which isn't too big. And your choice was red and blue, but I'm not going to use the red or the blue. I got some Z LEDs that I'm going to wire into it instead. And I got six of the warm white for the bottom, and I got some cool whites for the top dome and some other areas. These are super tiny. So what I'm going to do is I'm simply going to cut off the three blue ones and then reuse them somewhere else, and wire six of these in, two per wire, so that it'll just repeat. And then what I'll do is I will have six, so I'll have like two this way, two this way, two this way. So the ones on the same wire will be opposite, and then I'll actually have six so that it'll just spin around. But any given time, you're going to have a light on either side, then it's going to move, and so on. So let me kind of show you what I'm talking about, or kind of show you how those are going to look, or at least with the blue ones in there right now. All right, so as I said, this is blue, and it's not going to be the final color. I just sort of taped the three of them in there, and you can see how they rotate in a circle. And go around. So I'm going to have six of them, and they're going to be the warm white instead of the blue. Let me show you how that looks on the bottom. Okay, so again, you can kind of see it gives you the illusion of it rotating. Not as obvious on the sides just yet because there's only three of them, but once there's the double number, it'll look better, and it's not going to be blue. As I said, they'll be the right color. So I'm going to use the same circuit for the top. All I'm going to do is wire either three per line or just two extras. I don't know if I want to use three on the top little dome, it's so small, or if I want to use just two, but run off the same circuit. So I'm going to use the white Z LEDs on the top, and I'll just put them in that tiny little hole there. I'll build some kind of styrene part for them, stick it up there at the bottom, and then do the same basic thing, and then they'll just rotate around. And with the super tiny Z SMDs or Z LEDs, they take up a lot less room. So there they are right there. Super, super tiny. So the bottom engine and that top dome will rotate in sync, and they'll be run off of the same circuit. And all of this will be outside of the kit. I'm gonna put a hole in the back of the bottom. I'm not quite sure exactly where, but somewhere down in here, and there'll be a tube, metal tube coming out of it, and all the wiring will come out of, including the lights for the interior. and that'll be mounted onto the base that I'm going to create, the little planet base. So, okay, so let me work on those a little bit. Okay, so I went ahead and put a coat of just the plain aluminum onto the kit of the all clads. I like it better. It still looks a little shinier in the video, but in real life it doesn't look that shiny. It's more of a dollar finish, which is more realistic, and it's more aluminum as opposed to the shiny. It's the more dull aluminum instead of the shiny aluminum. So I'm not turning it upside down because I'm experimenting with a little clear dome on top there. I'm not quite sure if that's the way I'm going to go with it. Using a googly eye or a wiggly eye. I have a whole pack of these from Hobby Lobby. Only problem is that it's not completely round. It has more of a flat edge. It's kind of hard to see it, but it's not perfectly round, so we'll see. I'll look around and see if there's anything else, but I do want to have that clear image, the clear dome. So what I'm starting to work with is some ideas on how to put the lights in the top of that dome. So I just took some thin styrene sheet. I just used a hole punch. I punched it out and then took out the little piece that it made. And it's a little bigger than that hole, but that's fine because it's going to be underneath and attached. So what I'll probably do, I want to put some holes in this, but I'll probably draw off a circle, put some holes in it first with a pin vise, and then use the punch to cut it out so it's easier to work with on the bigger sheet. And then I can look at putting some lights in it. And wiring in the SMDs into the bottom of it. So, okay. All right, so I'm trying to create the little mechanism in the top where the bubble is to show the lights blinking as though they were rotating. So on the ship itself, you have two curved little antenna scoops, and it actually spins on the ship, but in this particular case it's not going to spin. I'm just going to have it stationary and lights are going to blink as if they're moving. So what I did was I cut out that little piece with the bottom of the hole punch. Used a pin vise to put two little holes through it. And then I took some thin styrene and I curved it. And I generally just bent it around an X-Acto knife for the round part of a needle file until I got it to be curved. And then I glued a bigger piece that I'm going to need, obviously. That's not going to fit in there. To make it easier to work with once they're glued together. So they're glued back to back, they're also glued to the base. So now what I can do is just cut them and shape them like a rounded curve that would fit inside that little dome. So let me go ahead and work on that. All right, and there is the kind of roughly made piece that goes in there. It's hard to get the curve in such a small area, but it does have the rounded shape of the dome. And then here's one of the wiggly eyes that I cut out to try to be a dome. It's not perfect, but I'm gonna keep working on that. And it fits over top. Okay, so when I have the two lights in it, they'll blink alternately back and forth, and it'll give it the idea of some movement. I thought about doing three, and I could do three, but it doesn't really have that in the top dome. It's only really two, and the thing is spinning. So we'll try that and see how that looks. And the inside mechanism would be painted silver or copper. I think it's copper, actually, to give it some detail in there as well. Okay. All right, so I painted the little teeny insert that I made. I used some metallic gray from Tamiya for the bottom flat part. And then I used some of my gold Alclad. I just brushed it on the metal part, the little scoops that'll reflect the light on either side. So the front edge of it was a little more spread apart than the back was, so I decided to drill through that and make a third hole, as you can see. So there'll be a third light coming through the top. Now what I'm going to do is, instead of putting the lights through the holes, I'm going to glue them on the bottom of each of these holes. So I widened them a little bit with another bigger pin vise drill bit. And I'm going to 5-minute epoxy the lights into those little holes facing upwards. So you'll get the light reflecting up into the dome, but it's not going to be super obvious. If they were up in the dome, you're going to see lights from the side. It's going to be too much. So, all right, let me go ahead and see about getting those lights glued into place, and we'll see how that effect will work. All right, so I just taped the SMD into place. I didn't tape it on the hole, obviously, but I taped behind it. First, I put a piece of tape onto the plastic to kind of hold it down, and then I put a piece of tape over the wire, two pieces to hold it down flat. And then I just mixed up some 5-minute epoxy, a piece of cardboard and some toothpick, and just dabbed it on, so now it's hardened. So I can go ahead and remove this and then do the same thing with the other two. It would have been a little tricky to do all three at once on this tiny little disc, but I can go ahead and do the same process with the other two. Okay, and there are all three of the little tiny Z LEDs glued into the back, the bottom of this little disc. Sorry for the focus, it's really tiny. There's the top of it. So two are on either side. One of them's in the front. Let's see if I can get closer. In that little groove. And some of the 5-minute epoxy came through the holes, which is nice, so that'll add to the lights. And then they'll rotate around. And illuminate that dome at the top. So, okay. So what I've started doing is I cut off all of the blue LEDs that came pre-wired with my rotator circuit. And it's a pretty small circuit, as you can see. It's pretty cool. And what I did first is I taped them all down, and I just made sure they were in the right sequence that I want them to be from left to right. So if I know that sequence, then I can wire them in. The bottom of the fusion core goes left to right, or if you were looking at the bottom, clockwise. The top is the opposite. It's going to be going counterclockwise, be in sync with the bottom. So if you're looking straight down at the ship, it's going to go counterclockwise. If you could see through the ship, the core would be going counterclockwise as well. Whereas if you flip the ship over, it's going clockwise. It'll make more sense when I get it all together. But as long as I know which one is 1, 2, and 3, I can wire the 6 from the bottom and the 3 from the top into the proper ones, because I'm going to have 3 per line, and so that they'll rotate in sync. All right, so let me go ahead and get this wired into the circuit, and I'll show you how that's gonna look. All right, so I'm gonna demonstrate how to remove the coating on the magnet wire. So Magnawar is nice because it's very thin and you know, small. You can put it in tight places, but it doesn't have your traditional plastic coating that you could really use a like a wire cutter, wire stripper to take off. It's more, it's almost like it's painted on. It's the red and the green. So the technique I've come down with, which is fairly straightforward, is you snip it off, you untwist the two wires to separate them. And then the first thing I do is I take just a lighter and I just burn off the end of it. Just heat it up a little bit. Okay, and I think that kind of loosens up the paint a bit, makes it easier to remove. And what I've done is I have this in a pair of pliers. All I did was I just put a piece of tape around the wire to protect it from the plier grips. And I just have it in between some pliers so I can pull on the wire without it pulling loose from the rest of the strand. And then all I do is I have a piece of sandpaper, which I folded in half. It's just, it's not like real heavy grit, it's just a finer one. And then I just take it, put it against the wire, and I just pull away from it and sand off the coating. Sorry if that's not in focus for you. And I move it around in a couple different directions. So I'll do it sideways at first, maybe like four or five times, then I'll do it up and down, that kind of thing. So okay, and then what it'll do is it will, after several back and forth, it'll remove the coating and give you a nice bare wire. And you can tell when it's bare, obviously, because it's copper. As you can see right there. Okay, so it's a little trickier, but I think it works pretty well, especially for the wire being as fine as it is. All right, so let me finish up this last one and we'll go ahead and test my my top rotating light. Okay, so I have that all wired up here to test it out. It looks pretty sweet. So three of them spinning around. So it looks on the bottom. Oh, sorry. There it is on the bottom. You're not going to see that part. I'll just probably flat black that so it won't light up on the inside, but it's doing exactly what I want it to do. Let me go ahead and get that in the kit and we'll see how that's going to look. All right, and there is the top dome light with a little clear googly eye dome on top. It's not permanently attached yet, but it's just kind of sitting there. I think it looks pretty sweet. So you got the rotating action going on there. I think it looks pretty realistic. It's not too bright. And again, the camera does make it look a little brighter than it actually is. I think that's pretty cool. And that'll be in sync with the bottom engine core as well, rotating in the same way, in the same sequence from left to right. So, okay. All right. So this has come along really well. The circuit's working perfectly here for me. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video for this week. Next week we'll be focusing on the engine core at the bottom. And then once I get both of these completed with the wires inside of them, I can go ahead and move on to the interior. So, all right. Thank you to all my new subscribers. Stay tuned and we'll be continuing on this really awesome little 3D printed Jupiter 2. All right, so that's going to wrap up the first part of this build. Next week, like I said, I'll be working on the engine core with the same idea that I did with the little dome at the top. So very happy with how that turned out.
Highly recommend Evan Designs. They have all different types of tiny little lights and circuits and pretty much anything that you could need or want to light up your kits, even something as tiny as this little Jupiter 2. So, all right, I will see everyone in about a week, and then we'll continue on the progress for this build. Thank you.